What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about installing VMware vCenter version 8. So let's get right into it.
Oh, sorry. You need some blueberries. So today is all about deploying VMware vCenter version 8. So this is how I did it. Now, the first thing that we need to do is you got to create an egg record. So I have a DNS server. I went inside my Active Directory. Within here, I went inside DNS Manager. I right-clicked. I went to New Host, A Record, and I provided a name, and I gave it vCenter, right? My full qualified domain name is going to be vcenter.btnhd.edu. Very important, you gotta make sure you have an internal DNS server working for vCenter to work properly. Now, in the past, I've dealt with vCenter, and if you do not have an A record or a DNS working properly, vCenter won't install correctly. So, past experience, make sure you do an A record. Now, the IP address that I'm going to provide is 192.168.1.130. Just click on Add. The host record, vcenter.btnhd.edu, was successfully created. Just click OK, and there goes our record. Now, let's go inside the folder where I have VMware 8.0 ISO. I'm going to right-click on that particular file. I'm going to pick on 7-zip, and I'm going to extract the files and click OK here. Now, I'm using 7-zip to extract all the files. Once that's done, I'm going to double-click on that folder, and within this folder, I'm going to go inside the VCSA folder, and you're going to see the OVA. Now, I've noticed that using the OVA and importing it into your ESXi hypervisor or into your workstation, you're going to have a lot of problems. So this is how you fix those problems. It looks like VMware has changed the way of importing this particular vCenter into your infrastructure. It's kind of weird, but this is how I did it. Now we're going to go inside the OVF tool folder. Right there, we're going to double click on it. We're going to go inside the Win32. And within this folder, I'm going to hold the shift key and right click anywhere inside the folder to get this nice prompt. Now I'm going to click on open PowerShell windows here. Now the command that we're going to use is the following. We're going to use the ovftool.exe file. We're going to give it the path of where that OVA file is located. And then we're going to give it another path and convert that OVA file to an OVF file. So hit enter here. It's gonna give you all this gibberish, which is good, and it's gonna give you a nice little progress bar. And once it's completed, you should get this. Completed successfully, awesome. That OVF file is created for us. So if you go inside that folder, you're going to see our new OVF file. Awesome. Now, next thing that we need to do is delete that MF file, that manifest file that was created for you. So just make sure you right click on it and delete it. Now we're going to select our OVF file. We're going to right click on it and I'm going to open it up within Notepad++. And I'm going to do a Control F and we need to locate this particular parameter and it's going to be upgrade.import. So just click on find next and you're going to locate it. Now we need to make some modifications here because if you import the OVF file or the OVA, you're gonna have a lot of problems. It's so weird. One of the problems is if you're trying to do a new installation, it's gonna think it's doing an upgrade. It's ridiculous. So we're going to change the parameter where it says user configurable to true. So where it says false, delete it and just convert it to true. Save the file. Once you save the file, open up your VMware workstation. Now I'm using VMware workstation 16.0. I think that's the version that I'm using right now on this particular machine. We're going to click on file. We're going to click on open and we're going to locate our OVF file. So select it, click on open, and you're going to get the import virtual machine in user license agreement. So we're going to accept the license and terms. We're going to click on next. We're going to provide our virtual machine a name and a path of where we want to drop it. So I gave it the following. So we're gonna click next here and pick your flavor. There's so many types of deployment options. Because I'm running a small shop, and I'm running everything on a laptop, I picked the default one, which was the tiny vCenter server with embedded PSC. So that's what I selected, and I clicked on next. And it's time for you to configure this section here. So provide the IP address, the network mode, network IP address, prefix, default gateway, all that following. So this is what I gave it. The address family is going to be IPv4. It's going to be a static. I gave it the following IP address. It's the same IP address that I used earlier at the beginning of the video with my A record. The prefix is 24. It is running a subnet of 255.255.255.0. That is why it is using 24. And the default gateway is the following, and the DNS is pointing to my Active Directory as well as I'm using Google's DNS. Why not? And the host network identity is the full qualified domain name that I use for my A record. Once you do all that, we're going to click import, and it's going to start importing. Now, once you import this particular OVF file within your VMware workstation, by default, the network connection is going to be a bridge. So I had a lot of problems. I wasn't able to contact or talk to my Active Directory with the subnet that it was providing. So I actually had to go inside the virtual machine settings and change it to a NAT. Once I applied it, it was working with no problem. Now, check this out. You have to change the root password because without the root password, you can't continue with the setup. So once you get here, we're going to press F2. And it's going to want you to enter a new password. So enter your new password, confirm the password, hit OK, and it's going to take you here. We're going to click on the escape key to log out because we're done. Now, open up your favorite browser. I open up Chrome, and we're going to type in the IP address of that hypervisor. Make sure you're using the port of 5480, as you can see right here, and just hit enter. It's going to load this. Your connection is not private. You know, it's legit. Click advanced. Click on proceed to whatever IP address your hypervisor is, and it's going to take you here. It's going to prompt you for your password. So just enter the password, click on login, and then you have four options. Now, the option that I want is setup because we're setting up a new vCenter server. So click on setup. We're going to click next here. And if everything works well, all the settings that you did when you were importing that OVF file into your VM workstation should be here. So just make sure everything is correct. The only thing that we need to do is change the time mode and give it access to your SSH, right? Change it, good to go, click next. Now it is time to configure your single sign-on configuration. So I give it the following. I gave it vspare.local. You can give it whatever you want. And then I gave it a password and then confirm it. And then click next here. I am not going to join the VMware Customer Experience Improvement Program. So I uncheck that. I click next here. Ready to complete, a nice little summary, and that summary looks good. We're going to click finish. It's going to give you a warning, so just click OK. It's going to go do its thing. I kind of walked away. I got a cup of coffee. When I came back, it gave me this. It reloaded itself to that. I was like, oh my God, it fell. It did not fail, so don't freak out. Just click on advance. Click on proceed to whatever IP address your vCenter is. It's going to take you here, provide the password, log in. If it logs in with no problem, it's going to reload and take you to the VMware vCenter server management. Again, this right here is with the port of 5480, so it's going to take you directly here. So just sign in, click login, and bam. I think the only warnings that I had was the memory. I might have to bump up this virtual machine's memory a little bit. I think by default, it gives you around 13.4 or 14 gigs, but best practice is to give it a little bit more. Now, open up a new tab and now type in the IP address of that hypervisor, your vCenter server. Hit enter, takes you here. This is a good thing. So click on launch vSphere client. It's gonna take you back to the connection is not private. Ah, crazy. Click on advanced, proceed to whatever full qualified domain you had. If you see your full qualified domain there, that is awesome. That means your DNS server is working the way it's supposed to work. That's how it's supposed to work. So click on it. It loads up, it takes you to this portal right here, VMware vSphere. So just enter your username and the password. Remember your single sign-on and click on login and it takes you here. This is a good thing. I think on the next video, I'm going to attach all my hypervisors to my vCenter and start playing around. I think I need to license this vCenter. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.